And the vanilla shit is super dope because they actually, I looked up an article based off of this whole mail we got. Hey, ladies, I'm a super fan of your podcast. Well, I was watching a comedy show called Speechless. Funny show, by the way.
Everybody keeps telling me to watch it.
I haven't seen it. It's about a child who is a paraplegic surviving life's challenges. In the episode, he was being discriminated by his girlfriend's father, so he wanted to be a bad boy, being that he has no feelings in his lower body. Anyways, long story short, he called for an aide, but the aide confused the call, thinking he requested a sex surrogate. Being that I know you guys do a lot of research on sexual things and WPS, would be an awesome discussion for your show. Anyways, thanks for reading, and I'll keep listening.
I've been looking for a sex surrogate,
and
we talked about it.
I didn't even know this shit was like for real, for real.
With Ashley's episode, Ashley, who is disabled, we talked about sex surrogate.
Oh, so see, yeah. So I wasn't here for that. So for those who may be like confused with maybe what a sex surrogate means, because when I hear surrogate, of course, I'm thinking of someone who holds a baby for someone else. So I went and did a little bit of research, and on
so
Bravo,
surrogate, I believe the word represents a replacement or like an alternate or like
sense.
A substitute. That's
okay.
Why.
So
it relates to holding
Bravo
a baby.
BravoTV.com. The article is: sex surrogates sleep with their clients to help their lives, and no, it's not prostitution. So sex surrogates actually work closely with sex therapists to help clients overcome sexual problems, such as erectile dysfunction or sex trauma, through actual physical intimacy.
Did it say anything
that
about them
sex.
Doing it for free? Because this is volunteer work in a lot of places.
So right, the very next question is, they make good money. Oh. Comparable to a sex therapist. And the laws are strict as to how sex is handled, so their career isn't confused with prostitution.
There's a Netflix thing. Damn, I wish I could fucking remember the name, with this older woman who takes people's...
She does that?
She takes people's virginities and helps them through that experience.
Really? So she would be considered a sex surrogate?
She is a sex surrogate, yeah.
Oh.
And so, like, she walks them through their first time in sex, and maybe I'm guessing it's not prostitution because there is a lot of therapy involved. Like, you don't just get there and you fuck. I think it's, like, an option that can happen. That's probably how they get around
this. So here's the laws. Sexual surrogacy has been legal since 2003. So it's fairly new to being legal. It's remained pretty much
unregulated.
Yeah, it's been pretty much unregulated. It has been defined by the state of California as, if it's between consensual adults and referred by licensed therapists and doesn't involve minors, then it is not illegal.
Mm.
Regulating the industry has mostly been
up. As long as you're fucking someone consensual, not kids or hurting animals, then you good.
They also have a whole association for it. So if you guys want to do further research into the industry, it's called the International Professional Surrogates Association. They credit
surrogate, Mandy.
That's what I said. Surrogate.
You keep saying surrogate.
Surrogate. Whatever. Same shit.
You saying
surrogate? Which they credit themselves with helping mostly men with physical disabilities, psychological traumas, or sexual shame.
Again. This gallon of water is killing me.
You're awful.
But keep going.
See, this is why she don't work no more, y'all, because she can't do a job. She can't hold a pussy. I actually did not know anything about this sex surrogacy being a thing. It is important to also be working with a sex therapist, though, to understand what's going on mentally and what's leading someone to certain thoughts. This is important because I say this often when it comes to sex, and we actually have a couple questions relating to the psychological aspects of sex and having sex with another person. A lot of sex is way more psychological than physical. And I know that we look for the physical touch and penetration and all of these terms to describe what sex is. But in order to reach the climaxes and orgasms and actually enjoy it to how we want to, you really need to be in a mental state in which you can allow these things to happen to your body. So this is interesting. If you guys want to look it up, again, they're called sex surrogates. That's Surrogates.